Hi there, I'm Lucy from BookWidgets, and in this video I'm going to talk about gamification, a big word that puts a smile on your students' faces. It's important that gaming in education comes with learning as well. That's why I'll show you how you can gamify Google Classroom with BookWidgets, game widgets, or exercises. I'll show you some examples and give you some great extra lesson ideas as well. I have 5 learning games for you in this video. But that's not really everything. Check out the link in the description to find 5 more learning games that go in Google Classroom. The first learning game is Bingo. Add your own images or words to the Bingo widget from BookWidgets and share the result with your students. Every student will get a different Bingo sheet. In this example, the teacher calls out digital times and the students have to tick off the matching clock. When a student has ticked off 5 in a row, he has Bingo. So what else can you do with a bingo game in your classroom? You can make a definition bingo. Read out the definition of a word and let the student find the word on the card. You can also make a picture vocabulary bingo. Use cards with pictures of the translated words you're calling out. Make a rhyme bingo. Call out rhyme words of the words on the bingo card. Make a decimal bingo. Put decimals on the card and either call out the numbers literally or as fractions. One of the most used learning games is a crossword puzzle. So that will be the second learning game. You're probably using it the ordinary way. You give a definition and students have to find the right term. As you can see in the example, a crossword puzzle can be more than that as well. Here are some other crossword puzzle ideas. Learning the elements of the periodic table isn't easy. It definitely is much more fun when you put the symbols and their names in a crossword puzzle. Geography also has its fair share of names to remember. Countries, cities, continents, mountain regions, rivers, and so on. And when you're teaching a foreign language, translations have to be made. Let your students translate the given word to the language you teach. The third game is Randomness. This is probably a learning game you've not seen before. Add images, numbers, words, or emoticons to wheels. Spin the wheels and see what comes up. Let your students come up with a story about some randomly given emojis. What a great speaking or writing exercise. Other possibilities are, let students build a correct sentence with words given by the randomness widget. Do experiments around probabilities. Roll the dice or flip coins. Add numbers to the wheels. Spin the wheel and let students multiply, divide, subtract, or add numbers. Number 4 is a pair matching game. Here, students have to match pairs. Here are some associations you can make pairs with. Words and their translation, images and their translation, arithmetics and their solution, images of people and their names, images of monuments and their names or places, words and their definitions, and much more. The last game, a word search puzzle, is a tricky one. Some students can find words immediately and others just don't. In most cases, students just have to find the given words, but you can spice things up as well. Most science subjects come with a lot of terminology to learn. Word search puzzles are perfect for the job of introducing scientific words in an interactive way. How about geography? Names of continents, countries, cities, rivers, mountains, give the capital of a country and let students search for the right country in the word search. When teaching languages, students could look for the translation of a given word. That's it for today. You can just download the BookWidgets plugin and start creating these games right inside Google Classroom. Check out the link in the description for that. Give this video a thumbs up if I gave you some new lesson ideas. Don't forget to subscribe as well. Bye!